trying to do. Hustle and motivate. Choppers and throwaway. Hustle the overweight. That's why they follow me, huh? They think I know the way. Cause I took control of things. Ball in the solo way. And if you pattern my trend, I make you my protege. Crossing that soldier race. Niggas don't know them days. Take you in back of the buildings. Make you expose your rage. Take you across.
Hello everyone, welcome to Sade's Tarot Tea. So today I am going to be doing a reading on Nipsey Hussle. May he rest in peace. I was thinking about waiting to do this video because I wanted him to be able to rest in peace. And I know there's going to be a lot of psychic readers that are, going to do a reading on him. But I want to go ahead and pull on his energy and see everything, what was going on around him at the time, not too long ago when he passed away. And also I want to look into Lauren London's energy and see what's going on. And also I will be doing an update when his energy settles more. I feel like it's only fitting that I do him because, you know, I'm a very sensitive soul, so I don't do this with jealous or crazy or weird intent or malicious intent. I want to honor Nipsey, and I can't really call myself a fan. I don't really know much about him. So, you know, guys, if, you know, everything isn't lining up perfectly, don't come for me because I know people are going to get very defensive. So we're just going to go ahead and pull on his energy. And I just want to look into him as a person and see what he was about. I feel called to do this with my my psychic heart tarot deck. Yeah, so let's go ahead and do that. Nipsey, I hope you're resting in peace. I very much apologize for what happened to you. And my heart and my prayers go out to London, Lauren London, excuse me. So yeah, let's see what's going to share the love. Okay, so he got the share the love card that just came out, and challenging times. So I feel like before Nipsey passed away, I feel like there was a lot of chaos going on around him. A lot of things were out of his control. A lot of things were confusing for him. And he didn't really, I feel like he was trying to like dodge a lot of people that wanted things from him, wanted, Nipsey had a lot of people that wanted money from him. A lot of, you know, he had a lot of people that, and I don't mean like he owed people money. I mean like he had a lot of people like pulling at him, like, okay, like we need money now, or can you help me with this? Like he was always someone that would like help you. Like he was someone that would reach out and give you money, give you whatever, you know, he needed. I know he's a really big advocate for the Black Lives Matter, the Black Lives Matter movement, African Americans, and just us as a union. He's always someone that he wore his heart on his hand, basically, he wore his heart on his sleeve. And I just pulled up his chart, actually, and because I wanted to get more into his energy. And he's a Leo sun with his moon in Leo, his Mercury in Leo, Venus in Cancer, and his Mars is in Leo. I don't know what his rising's in, but that's okay. So yeah, that's so far what I'm pulling for him. Yeah, he just got the heel card. Nipsey's actually a lot more at peace now. There's a lot that he had to confront before he passed, and as he was passing. And actually, like, when Nipsey went up to heaven, like, God was standing right there, waiting with his arms open. And he was telling him, like, you need to break the chains that bind you. That's what I just heard. You need to break the chains that bind you. Because, you know, actually, guys, Nipsey didn't, of course, like, he was murdered. But he didn't want to go like that. But there was a lot that, you know, Nipsey was kind of battling on this planet that a lot of people didn't know about. Because he was all about spreading love and spreading joy, but there was a part of Nipsey that his heart, trying to save everyone else, trying to preserve everyone else, was kind of cracking. And I actually pay attention to the heart cracking. Also, there were a lot of people that, you know, wanted to see that, I want to say like past like homies or homies that he had, that he, you know, that he had would, you know, they were trying to confront him. There was a lot that Nipsey had to confront, but he was running from a lot of things that were binding him, actually. And I even hear that Lauren was trying to get him away from that life. I know he was, I read that he actually was, a part of the gang life, you know what I mean? She actually wanted him to stop. She wanted him to break those ties. A lot of people, like, I always say this for celebrities that have to do with that type of life, but there are people that, as I said that, yeah, there are people that, yeah, wow, guys, oh my god. There are people that Nipsey trusted way too much, and, you know, he knew, Nipsey was someone that was, like, a self-reflector. I'm even seeing him, like, stand in front of a mirror. Like, he would, I don't know if you guys know this, being his fan, but actually he would do this in private more so, but he would stand in front of the mirror and he would say, like, things to himself. He would say things like, you know, like, I am the king, like, I am this, I am that, like, I am the one that will raise our generation up. I am the one that will help our generation. But there was still, like, a lot that he needed to heal from, being, actually, even when he was a little boy, like, I'm seeing him as a little boy, he had a lot of things that hurt him, and he wanted to be different, he wanted a community of people to raise him up, to raise his people up, and, as well, and unfortunately, he didn't see a lot of those people stepping forward, so he was like, well, I need to step forward, you know, I need to be the one to raise our people up, to raise not just, you know, the African-American community, although he was a very big advocate for the African-American community, but I'm hearing more so to, like, everyone, you know, and the youth too. And like I said, when he passed, God welcomed him right into heaven. But there's some things that he needs to let go of and confront. And you know what's interesting, guys, as I get more into Nipsey's energy, he actually will come back. He's gonna come back. Like, I don't mean like be resurrected or anything like that. I mean, like, spiritually, he has to come back and relive a cycle so he can move into more into the gates of heaven. And he was a very trusting person too. He trusted the wrong types of people, but at the same time, he was a very suspicious person. Like, he knew that there were people around him that he couldn't trust. Like, he knew that. But he was going through some really tough shit before he passed away, before he was murdered. He was going through some really tough shit, guys. Like, I don't think people realize, like, Nipsey, his energy is telling me he's a man that, like, you wouldn't know, because he's so confident and he's so, like, he's not a boastful type of person, like, in the ways you would think. Like, he likes to walk like he's a king, and like, that's so Leo. Like, that's very, like, men that are, like, Leos, you know what I mean? And he liked that people saw him as this person. He liked that, like, it touched his heart. Like, he's very connected to his heart chakra. He's very, something about the heart keeps coming out. He's such a person of love and understanding and perfectionism and how we love people. Like, he always tried to do the right thing. He always tried to say the right thing. And he has his Venus in Cancer, actually. So that's telling me a lot too. And he was one that too, when people were hurting, he would always open up his arms to them. But Nipsey still needs to break those chains that bind him. There's still some healing he has to do, guys. There's still some healing. There's still some truth that will come out about him. We'll see, of course, you know, we'll see more stuff come out in the tabloids about him. We'll see more news come out. We'll find out who murdered him. I believe it was someone that Nipsey was very, like, closely associated with that ran up and shot him. Someone that he trusted way too much, that was a part of his murder. So even I'm getting that this man was, like, hired, like, this man. So I don't know if this guy was a part of a gang, or, you know, I don't want to just say that, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know if this man was a part of a gang. I don't know if, you know, he was hired by a gang member to murder him, But that's kind of what I'm getting. So if you guys know anything about that, in the I know, like I said, some truth still has to come out about him. So, but yeah, that's what I'm getting. Ugh, so sad. Poor London. I mean, I keep calling her London. Poor Lauren too. Like Lauren is, she is hurting. Yeah, like guys, like look what is coming out for him. Like he is being released. I'm telling you guys, there was a lot that Nipsey was going through that people did not know about. There was a lot of hurt, a lot of pain that he was holding on to. He was that type of man that like would harbor people's pain. Like he would harbor that, being a Venus in Cancer, he would harbor that. And it's saying that he needs to release himself, release the past, release these people that he thought trusted, that he could trust. You know, that's what keeps coming out for him. And oftentimes, you know, what's interesting is that Lauren would tell him, like, she would always, they would get into like little arguments about this because, you know, I don't know what Lauren is, but you know, I think I looked up her chart, but I forgot. But you know, she would tell him like, you know, babe, you need to stop. Like you need to move away from that life. She didn't support him being in that type of life, you know, because she knew it was dangerous. And actually, you know what's interesting, guys? Lauren had a premonition. She had a premonition that he was gonna get murdered. She would have dreams, or she would have these like deja vu moments where she would warn Nipsey, like, yo, like you, I don't think she talks like that, but you know, she's like, you need to be careful, you need to move like this. You know, she's a very cautious person like that. So I'm wondering what is in Lauren's chart, because I am seeing her being very psychically intuitive like that. So let's see. I did try to look up her birth chart. Oh, I did look it up. Oh, she's a Sagittarius. Okay, but let's see. Okay, she has her moon in Taurus, she has Capricorn energy, but Capricorns can be very intuitive as well. People think only water signs can be intuitive. No, Capricorns are very intuitive. And she's very smart like that. She was just like, she would tell him, or she would have these fears, like, or she would wake up from dreams. And she had dreams, guys. She had dreams that Nipsey would get murdered. Like, she, I'm not just saying that, guys. Like, she would try to tell him, like, you know, I don't know, I just keep having this feeling, like, and it's not only from stemming from her, like, fear of him being a part of that life, because he did try to hide that a lot from her. Like, she knew that he was a part of that life, but he would try to tell her, like, so she wouldn't worry, like, babe, I'm about to put that down, don't worry about that, like, I'm gonna, like, put that to rest, you know. I don't know if he says that a lot, but he would tell her, like, I'm gonna put that to rest, like, I'm gonna put that to rest, you know. But more stuff is coming out too, guys. More truth. Lauren too is gonna get a lot of things. Lauren is gonna, I don't know what type of assets Nipsey had, but Lauren is gonna get what she deserves. Like, what, because she stood by his side. She was that ride or die chick. Like, she knew a lot of what Nipsey was a part of, like, which was some dark stuff. It kind of reminds me of Tupac in this way. He's the Tupac of our generation, really, is what that energy is, what I'm getting. And you know what people are feeling for him. Yeah. So let's see what happened that day. Let's see what happened that day. Oh, guys, you guys, this is a dark topic. So sad. And it was, like, really weird to do this because I know this tarot reader that people are wanting her to do this reading on him, but she wants him to rest, and I do too. So that's why I'm not really channeling his energy. I want him to rest because I feel like, you know, he was going through a lot of pain before he passed away. But I just want to know, like, I just want to see, like, what happened. So can you tell me what happened around Nipsey's death? What was going on before and after? Okay, so the Three of Wands just came out. He was actually, he was doing a mini, like, tour. I know he was outside of his clothing store, but he was traveling. He was really busy. He was busy a lot. He was constantly on the go, and three people, I'm hearing two as well as this being the Three of Wands, three people were keeping their eye on Nipsey. They were trying to see like where he would go, like they were keeping tabs on him. And one of the guys that actually shot him was the one of the ones that was sent by one of that three of these guys. This middle wand I'm seeing, that was the main person that was keeping tabs. They would actually take turns looking at what Nipsey was doing. They would take turns like wondering what was going on with him. They had been planning this for a while, guys. They had been planning to shoot him for a while. Actually, I'm hearing about 3 years as well. And the Emperor. Yeah, I'm pulling fire energy. So one of the people that this could be the guy that shot him. He's an Aries, or the middleman. The middleman is the one that either shot him or was planning the whole thing. And the middleman is, I'm pulling that he's an Aries, and he's a man of power. He's a man of, you know, this could also be Nipsey, because Nipsey was reaching a point in his life where he was doing really well. And if you notice, like I notice, when I do these readings on these celebrities that pass, the ones that go way too soon, they actually always get like shot, right, or die before they reach a pivot in their career. And that's what was going on with these three people. Were jealous of him, and you know, actually I'm hearing too that Nipsey was trying to break away from that life, actually, because of Lauren. Like, she was a really big influence for him. She was teaching him how to, I think I read a quote about this too, like him saying this, like she was teaching him how to be a man. Like, she was teaching, and I say that with respect, you know what I mean? Like, she was teaching him the proper way to be a man, how to be a, you know, I don't know if Nipsey had a baby with Lauren, but I'll look that up after. But something about him, like, being a father, like, he's a very protective type of person too, with that Leo and Cancer energy, and whatever his rising's in. He could be an Aries rising too, but yeah. Four of Wands. Yeah, this signifies him reaching a pivot in his career too. Like, he was reaching a moment, guys. He was on top, like he was on his throne, and these three people, these were the main people that had it out for him. But I'm getting that middle wand. If you notice that middle wand, I'm noticing that's the one that wanted, he was the main influence of planning or actually shooting Nipsey. I know what happened around Nipsey's death. Why was he shot? Why was Nipsey shot? Why was Nipsey shot? Nipsey's actually, guys, I'm feeling from his energy, he's really upset. I mean, why wouldn't he be? But he's really, like, when Nipsey's upset, like, my hands shake, but when Nipsey's upset, like, he like, shakes. Like, he gets, like, so angry because he has that Leo energy, he has that fire energy. So when he gets mad, he gets so, like, he actually is in so much, like, that's what I was pulling from this deck, like, my psychic heart of the tarot deck. He's so angry right now. Like, he's in flames. Like, I'm in more of his energy now. And he and God is trying to get him to release that anger, because he can't. It's too soon right now, of course, because he just passed. But Nipsey has to release himself of that anger. And I was kind of saying that in the beginning of my video. I was kind of saying something like that. But he's so angry, guys. Like, you don't understand the anger I feel from him. It's like... Nine of Swords just came out. Two of Swords, Ten of Cups. Oh, I think this is Lauren coming out. She's a Sagittarius, but that doesn't matter. She is not okay, guys. Of course, why wouldn't she be? You know, her love of her life just passed. Like, of course she'd be upset. Ten of Cups in the reverse. Yeah, guys, he's really unhappy right now. He's like, but he actually, when he passed, he wasn't in his right mind, actually. He was fighting, even though Nipsey was reaching this pivotal moment in his career. A lot of times, Nipsey, guys, he would lay awake because he was so afraid. Like, Nipsey, too, had a feeling that he would always have to watch his back. Like, he had a feeling, too, and Lauren being in his ear, too, like, he always had a feeling like these people were, like, out to get him. He always had a feeling like I wouldn't say he knew when or where he was going to get shot, because it became a surprise to him. And when he walked out of the store, I'm seeing, guys, like, there was a man in a black coat. Like, what kind of black coats are those where they're, like, not those bomber jackets. Yeah, I guess kind of like those bomber jackets. But the guy was like this, and he walked up, he goes, "Nipsey," like that, and he goes, "Pat," like, then he just shot him, and Nipsey was just like, like, he just, like, stopped, and he's like, and people were screaming, like, that's why, because my sister was like, "I don't understand how, like, no one knew, like, this man had a gun, or, you know, or there were no witnesses, you know." Well, the reason is because, well, of course, they all saw, like, they didn't see it because it was so fast. Like, I'm telling you guys, they have been planning this for a while. Like, they have been planning this. They have been following Nipsey, and they knew where he was gonna be. And Lauren would tell him, she was like, "You need to watch your back." She would also, I heard earlier too, she would beg him to get security. So I don't know if you guys know if he has, like, a bodyguard or if he had, like, security around him, but I'm hearing that when he went to the store, he went to his shop, he didn't have security around him that day. But something told Nipsey he should have had security around him. And Lauren had actually kept telling him, like, "Babe, you need to get security around you. Like, you need to get security around you," because she knew he was a part of that life. And Nipsey was like, "Nah, shawty, don't worry about it." Like, I don't know if he said shawty a lot, but I heard that. But this guy, I don't know if he's bald, or he doesn't really have hair. But he's a black dude. I can see his skin tone. He's black. He's kind of short, so you kind of have to look to see him, and that's why they made him do it. And he kind of, like, he's like, hey Nipsey, that's what he said. And Nipsey's just like, "What?" Like, okay. And then he's like, "Pat," like, he just did it real quick, and then he left. Like, so it was, like, quick, like, the gunshot, like, how fast he hit him was quick, and he had, like, a full, like, shot to him. I think he hit him in the chest. It was in the chest. And it hit his, like, they were trying to revive him. I read a little article about it, but people thought Nipsey was gonna pull through, but the gunshot hit him, like, it had really, like, nicked him or something. Like, I heard nicked him, but the part where it nicked him, so I don't know where it got him exactly. I just know the chest area. But it was too late. Like, they couldn't revive him, unfortunately. But they were trying to revive him. Also, I'm hearing too, when Nipsey was going into the light, Lauren was, like, crying over him, and he could hear Lauren crying. Like, he could hear him. He could hear her crying, and when she had gotten to him. And some people think that when your life is leaving, when the soul is leaving the body, that they can't hear anything anymore. But actually, Nipsey was a little bit responsive. He was kind of responsive for a minute, because Lauren got there in time, like, to say her goodbye. Because I think she kind of, like, waited, and then they're like, "You gotta say your goodbye," or whatever. And so, this is when they had put him in the hospital, guys. So there's nothing, I don't think there's anything out there yet. And remember, like, I see everything. So just because you guys don't know, it doesn't mean that it didn't happen, okay? Because I know I might get some people like, "Oh my God, that didn't even fucking happen," like, blah, blah, blah. Listen, like, you guys don't have to believe me. That's fine. But that's what I'm hearing, okay? So I know I've been getting some trolls lately, and people are just, like, doubting me. So that's fine. You can doubt me. I don't care. I know that there are going to be people that do believe what I'm saying. That's okay. Everybody has their own opinion. But guys, I'm hearing that as Nipsey was passing, Lauren was actually, like, crying over him. Just crying over his shoulder. His body. And he was trying to fight. He was trying to fight to stay alive. But unfortunately, where the gunshot hit him, it took him out. Like, not right away, because they were able to get him. And I did read, like, a little bit about that. Just a little bit. Because I didn't want to read anything because I wanted to do this reading on him. I just kind of ran across it, but Lauren was crying. He could hear her. He was kind of receptive a little bit, like his hand kind of moved, so they thought they were going to be able to revive him. But unfortunately, of course, you guys know that they didn't. That's what I'm pulling. So that's what I'm pulling. This is dark energy, guys. Oh my god, poor Nipsey. Okay, but yeah, he actually, before he passed, there was a part of Nipsey that wasn't happy because he wasn't mentally there, because he lived a lot of his life in fear. But you wouldn't know that because he was about uplifting the people. He wrote that song, F Donald Trump, and he's all about that. But he knew at some point that was gonna catch up to him. You know, people probably think that, you know, Donald Trump has something to do with this because Nipsey wrote that song, but there were people that were upset about that. But I'm getting more so there was a black man that shot him, so that was a part of the gang. He was a part of the gang. And yeah, I keep seeing like this short, he's not super short, but I'm seeing this kind of like short black guy that did it really fast. Let me know if you guys know anything about that. That's what I'm seeing. So people are probably thinking it was a white guy or something, but I'm seeing a black dude. So let's see like what's going on about Lauren, because oh god, I can only imagine how Lauren's feeling right now. Ooh. Okay, please tell me Lauren's energy. Show me Lauren's energy about Nipsey. Lauren has a lot of people around her right now. She is actually really, she's on edge. She's more so right now, I'm feeling she's on edge than she, it kind of hasn't hit her yet. Like it's hit her, but it hasn't hit her. She's just been in her head all this time. What's going on with Lauren? This is her energy, Queen of Wands. She keeps getting swords. So this speaks of like, she's actually surrounding herself with support system. People around Lauren right now won't let her be alone. And she's trying to focus on work. She has that moon in Taurus, guys, so she's not dealing with her emotions. Like, she's not dealing with it. She's more so in her head about it. She's more so in her mind about it. And she's trying to put on this brave front. Actually, she's very hurt. I'm not saying that she's not crying. I'm not saying that she didn't cry. She did cry. But she's trying to move forward. And the reason I'm feeling this from her is because I'm not saying she doesn't care. It's just that Lauren, when she deals with her pain, it hasn't sunken in for her. So it's like she wakes up and she thinks that he's gonna, like, she wakes up, she thinks that he's gonna be there. She wakes up thinking that it's just a dream. She lies to herself a lot like that. And that happens when, you know, when people pass away, that happens. And she's not taking a break. Like, she's just trying to focus on, her, like, things around her. She's trying to get her money situation. Lauren's just trying to figure out how to, like, she's more so in it. She's an action type of person. So she, like, sprung into action. Or she's springing into action. And if you notice, the Queen of Wands is in the upright. So she's like, she's springing into action. Like, she's like, what do I need to do to figure out? She's trying to get the assets together. She's trying to figure out how to get things situated for Nipsey's funeral. Because they want to have a big, like, funeral for him. They want to have a big ceremony. There's a big ceremony that they're going to have for Nipsey where I think fans are going to be able to come out. They're going to have a private funeral, and then they're going to have a whole viewing thing and a whole thing for him. So Lauren's actually trying to figure out how to get that situated. So that's what I'm feeling from her. Yeah, Eight of Cups. She's very, like, but she's, like, she is heartbroken right now. But she has people around her that are kind of, like, supporting her. But I'm telling you guys, it hasn't sunken in for her yet. Ace of Swords in the reverse. She's not okay, but she's like, what I feel from her, she's like Ace of Pentacles. Yeah, she's trying to get his assets together. She's trying to make sure that people don't go after his music. She's trying to make sure, like, her family is safe, because I'm getting to that they're, like, she's scared. Like, she's scared that the people that came after Nipsey are gonna come after their, like, come after her family, come after her. So she's trying to, like, hire, like, security. She's trying to lock, like, her house down. She's trying to, like, Lauren is in action right now, guys. She is in action. She got the Queen of Wands. She's just in her head, and she's like, what do I need to do to figure out how to, like, make sure I'm safe, how to make sure my family's safe? Plus, on top of that, she is trying to get the funeral and everything, because there's a lot that they need to get situated for him. She wants him to have a good funeral. She wants him to have a peaceful passing. And actually, I am feeling too that Nipsey's gonna try to come to her in her dreams and everything like that. I do feel like Nipsey was very protective over Lauren. So yeah. But I'm not seeing a lot of cup energy for her. I'm seeing more so swords. Yeah, she's trying to figure out how to like get things situated, how to be stable. She's trying, guys, this is so Taurus energy right now. Her moon is in Taurus, so she's just trying to stable her emotions. She's trying to keep her emotions in check. Like she does cry, but when she's in front of people with that Queen of Wands energy, she doesn't cry in front of people, guys. Lauren, and not saying that she doesn't care, Lauren does not cry in front of people. She doesn't like crying in front of people. I can't find the Queen of Wands here. I'm shocked. Like, she does not, but that's Taurus moons for you. Like, they don't like breaking down in front of people, and she's a Sag too, so she's just like, no. Like I am in touch with my emotions, but I'm kind of like pushing it down and suppressing my emotions because I don't want to deal with the truth of this. You know, she's just more so mentally in her head. Like, what do I need to do to make sure that he's okay? And that my family's okay? Like, whew. So, let's see how Nipsey felt about Lauren. Let's see, I'm curious. Let's see how Nipsey felt about Lauren. How did Nipsey feel about Lauren? Interesting. Okay, so he definitely saw Lauren as his, I feel like he saw her as his queen for sure. She's getting the Empress, so I don't know if Lauren is pregnant, or if they had a kid together. I'll put that here, if they had a kid together. I don't know, like I said, I don't know a lot about them. So either she's pregnant or with his kid, another kid they are having together, or you know, she has a kid with him. But he sees her as, you know, someone that's, this is like queen energy. The Empress in tarot is like the biggest honor you can get. Especially when a man sees you as the Empress, like that is beautiful. Like, he sees her as very nurturing, as very kind and compassionate. He sees her as someone that's a hard worker, very, you know, very much a go-getter, very victorious in whatever she does. She puts her mind to everything she does. She's very passionate. He feels that from her. She is, they're actually, guys, this is interesting. They are each other's twin flames. This is the Star card here. Also could be soulmate energy. It's not the Lovers, which is soulmate energy, but it's definitely, like, he felt that she was his soulmate, honestly. He was so in love with her. Like, that's beautiful. I feel it, you know? And he saw her, like, he was very, like, dependent on her, but in a good way. Like, it was in a way where he had a lot of, this is the Nine of Pentacles with the Nine of Wands. Two nine cards. I don't know if they were together for 9 years or 9 months. If you guys know anything about that too, just let me know. But two nines are coming out here. So there's a part of him that was dependent on her because she saw the good in him. She saw the potential in him. She always, like, was very patient with him, very nurturing with him, and he needed that, which is like what he loved about her. But also with this fire energy, like I was saying, he's very protective over her, and my eye goes to the angel. So now, like, Nipsey wants to be an angel, but God is telling him, in order to be an angel, you have to let go. You have to come to terms with, you know, the fact that you're gone. Like, you have to move forward. You have to heal. You have to release. But yeah, it's beautiful. This is beautiful energy. Seven of Wands too. He felt like he won, man. He felt like he won when he had been with Lauren. He felt like he was winning. He had his woman, he had his career. You know, Nipsey was feeling good. He was feeling on top of the world, but there was a part of him as he was reaching his pivotal moment, he was fearful. He kept getting scared. You know, he kept getting more and more scared. The magician in the reverse speaks a lot. But he I'm telling you guys, there was something about Nipsey where he was scared. He didn't really manifest his fullest potential because he was so afraid. There's a part of him, even though you guys see him so confident. Sometimes Leos do that. They're very good at making people think that they're very, like, invincible. You know, but I'm feeling from him that there were times where he wasn't. And he was able to let his guard down around Lauren. And that's one of the things he really appreciated about her. Because he was always that guy, that boy, that was, like, you know, like, he had it together. He was the youth, the voice of his youth. He was the voice of the Black community. He liked that image. He held that image to... He didn't take that image lightly. Like I was saying about Selena and Aaliyah. You know, same with Nipsey. Like, he really, like, owned that title, like, proudly. So, before I end this video, let's see how Lauren feels about Nipsey. How does Lauren feel about Nipsey? How does Lauren feel about Nipsey? How does Lauren feel about Nipsey? How does she feel about Nipsey? Oh. She's coming out as the Queen of Swords again. Okay. She actually felt on top of the world when she was with him too. She felt like she was winning too. She did feel like that. When she would be unstable, like Nipsey would catch her, like he would be there for her too. But there were times where, you know, she was unstable as well because she was so worried about him. Three of Cups in the reverse. There were times, guys, where their relationship suffered a bit. And I did feel this from their energy with photos and stuff. I felt like there was sometimes a certain type of disconnect because there was that fear there. And I'm telling you guys, like, it wasn't because there wasn't love there, okay? They have a great friendship, they have a great relationship, but Lauren would try to warn him a lot of times. Like, she was fearful of him, for him, guys. I'm telling you guys, she had a feeling this would happen. Like, she had a feeling, and I would not say that if I didn't feel it. Like, she had a feeling, she would have a premonition that this would happen. She would warn him, like, all the time. You know, and she actually didn't want him. Yeah, strength card in the reverse is coming out. You know, she didn't want him to go on. She didn't want him to take certain deals, actually, because not because she wasn't supportive, but because she's very supportive of him. But some of the deals that Nipsey was getting, I'm feeling, would put him in danger. Like, you know, like, or some of the events or, you know, shops he would go to that he had, or deals he had, would, you know, leave him open for exposure. And she was scared. She was so scared of that for him. But she feels like, too, with the Star card, she feels like they were destined to be together. There is that love and that exchange of twin flame energy. And she learned a lot from him. Like, he was, like, she was, they were each other's worlds. So that's what I'm feeling. And when she wasn't strong, I'm telling you guys, he was her rock. Like, he would catch her. And that's, you know, a position that Nipsey held. Yeah, like, very victorious relationship, guys. Very victorious relationship. The only thing I'm feeling from them is that they were scared. Nine of Pentacles, and there was that codependency there, but it was out of fear, you know? There was that fear. Lauren was scared for him a lot of times because, you know, he was in that life, or he was trying to get out of that life, but as he was reaching his pivotal, he was too in that life to get out of that life, if that makes any sense. So, yeah. The Empress, she's coming out. Does anybody know if she has a kid with him? I'm gonna look it up, but I'm getting that she has a kid with him, or that she was pregnant. She's pregnant with his kid. She might be pregnant again. So, yeah, you guys let me know. But that's what I'm getting. Also, I'm feeling Nipsey had more stuff that was destined for him. I'm also getting, too, that he wanted to release a liquor line or something having to do with liquor. Like, he wanted to do like what P. Diddy was doing. He wanted to do something like that, or like, and be also more of a voice for the youth. He's a big advocate for the youth too, like young Black males. Like, he's a big advocate, and of women too, like, you know. So I am getting that. And I know he had a clothing line. He wanted to further extend that. And but see, Three of Wands, and I got the Three of Cups. I'm telling you, there was some three type of energy that had it out for him. So yeah, let me know what you guys think of this reading. like I said, please be polite in the comments. You know, if I see any rude comments, you're getting blocked and deleted. So I say that out of respect. It's not to be mean. I want this to be a safe place. I want everyone to be able to talk, and this isn't about who's right or wrong or anything like that. Like, you know, I pulled on this now because I want to, you know, honor his name, and I haven't gotten the chance to do a video after somebody has passed, so I wanted to see about him, and I was curious, and I'm not, you know, I can't call myself a fan because I don't know anything about him. I have heard one song from him, which is the F. Donald Trump song, and my sister is, like, a big fan of his, so I wanted to do this to honor the Nipsey fans. So I hope you guys love this video, and I hope this brings Nipsey fans some type of peace, okay? More information is going to come out about his death and who shot him. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. This was Sade's Tarot Tea. If you would like to book a personal reading with me, you can book me at elegantflapper92 on my DM, or you can email me at sadestarottea@yahoo.com. Thank you guys so much for watching. Rest in peace, Nipsey. We honor your name. We salute your raps. We salute your talent. And let's just pray for Lauren, okay, guys? And her and the family, Nipsey's family. All right, bye, guys.